Yes, yes, yes. It's the Date Master, and we're back. Oh, we have a very revealing and interesting conversation yet again. The Beyonce ego and why rejecting men gives her power. I was just speaking about this, I believe maybe a month or two ago with one of my guys. And I said, I'm noticing a trend, and I'm seeing other, you know, creators notice this as well. Women are now getting power and confidence, not based upon the men that they can, you know, sleep with, get attention from, you know, get in a relationship with. They're now getting the validation and the ego stroke or the ego vitamins that I mentioned from rejection, from rejecting men. If you notice, and I've been noticing this for a little bit over a year, where women take these scantily clad photos showing their shape, showing their print, showing their silhouette, showing their bodies pretty much 2 to 3 times a week, if not every day of the week, and make these outrageous posts about the men in their inbox. It's almost equivalent to Jordan putting his best-selling shoes on sale for clearance at a physical store with a date. And when millions of or hundreds of people come to buy said shoes that are on clearance, the store managers are looking at them and the store workers are looking at the customers lined up outside like damn fools, as if, why are you here? Well, Mr. Store, or well, Jordan, you got these top, you got your best shoes on clearance from this ad that I saw this week. And it said they'll be available today. This is the equivalent to what women, the female logic, post my ass to the camera, show my pussy print 2 to 3 days a week, and hope no man contacts me about it, or hopes it doesn't get any attention from men. So what they're doing now is using their rejection of men as some type of form of empowerment. I call it the Beyonce ego, because this is one of the, if not the most influential female artists in the last 25 years. This is the most influential artist to where she sells you one thing and she does the total opposite. She says she's irreplaceable, yet she's in a relationship. She says all the single ladies, yet she's in a relationship, married with kids. And these women are eating this up. So these women adopt this mindset without truly looking at her lifestyle. So these women's ego grows exponentially every second or every chance they get the opportunity to reject or ignore a man who's trying to shoot their shots. Noticing this, these women are putting, you see it on your social media, where these women, at one point in time, they will block out the name of the guys who randomly stalks them. And I get it. You know, you guys are too thirsty. You're doing all of this type of ignorance. You're showing all of this attention to a woman who has not acknowledged you, who has not given you any indication that there is a mutual attraction. So you keep shooting your shot. You keep shooting your shot. Some cases, it's not even that to that extent. And they show the guy's name, profile, and who is this? Why are you shooting your shot at me? I'm above you. I see it on these platforms. I reject guys with blue check. I reject guys that are verified. And verification is synonymous with success. The verified profiles are synonymous with having some type of social status and financial status. So these women go out their way to reject these men because to them it gives them power. Oh, I've been engaged. You hear the engagement queens. Shout out to Kevin Samuels. The engagement queens, they always have to admit or confess how many times they've been engaged. It's always, I've been proposed to 3 times. I've been engaged to 2 times. Well, where are they? Well, where are they? I told you guys in a previous video, women do not call off engagements from men they truly want to be married with. In fact, they try to speed up the process. They try to expedite the process. If she truly wants to be married to you, she's going to go out her way to expedite the marriage process. If it's not, if she doesn't have any urgency about expediting it or any enthusiasm about the whole process in its entirety, you're just the person that is going to put her on a pedestal for a day or for a moment in time. She's going to go out her way to announce the engagement. You notice this. They go out of their way to announce the engagement. They get engaged at 12:59 p.m. It's 14 posts on Facebook and Instagram by 1:03 p.m. It's 14 posts on Instagram and social media by 1:04. 3 minutes later, she didn't even tell her mother first. She didn't even tell her parents first. She had to tell social media first. But when she calls off the engagement, she does it as quiet as a mouse. She calls off the engagement as quiet as you can hear a rat piss on cotton. You notice this, right? Rejecting men gives her power because it fills her ego. Because she has this grandiose concept that even a man of means, a man of high value is not enough for her. And she's basic. You got these basic women, average earning women, because let them tell it, every woman that gets on camera makes six figures. Let them tell it, every woman that comes on camera has a social media platform, makes six figures, but they don't incorporate the debt to income ratio where you're making $100,000 a year, but you're spending 60. You're spending 60 a year. You're spending 50 a year, and not including taxes, not including the upkeep of the image that they try to portray, which includes the makeup, the hair, the nails, the wardrobe. These are pretty expensive bills to a woman. That's why she's always looking for a sponsor. Because ask yourself, a woman who has all this money, why would they be looking for men with money if they don't need them for said money? It doesn't make sense. So you guys shoot your shot. These women are now making it sport and they're going out of their way to garner the attention from men, all in all hopes to reject them the moment the man takes a liking and shoots their shot. These women got damn near butt naked pictures on Facebook and Instagram complaining about the men treating them like a whore and coming at them like a whore. This is this Beyonce ego complex. These mainstream media and society knows. You think these women get on these platforms out of just what? It's millions of beautiful women. Not all women are going to sell themselves out and whore themselves out for fame and fortune. Not all women have what it takes to drive, the endurance, the perseverance to do whatever it takes to get in the room with the board of the Met Gala. You look at this Met Gala event and you look at these rappers and why they're dressed the way they're dressed. Ask yourself, who's funding and who's over this Met Gala to where they can get the attention and all of these artists to come and partake in the festivities? These women don't get these platforms just because of their talent. Because when you listen to the content, they're not talking about shit. They're not talking about shit. Where's your female equivalent to J. Cole? Where's your female equivalent to Kendrick Lamar? Where's your female equivalent to Common? Where are they? Where are they? Non-existent. So Beyonce and others have been giving women false hopes, false idols. All of the women Cardi B, Meg Thee Stallion, Beyonce, etc., live a lifestyle contradictory to their music when you listen to the lyrics. And their main, all the single ladies, Beyonce hasn't been single in damn near 15 years, 20 years almost. Jay-Z started vetting her when she was 19. Jay-Z is a very intelligent male. He's top tier. He's not a fool. So this Beyonce ego that is plaguing our dating market and the dating pool is only going to backfire, because what goes up must come down. These women get a high from rejecting men to the severest extent. They want to go extra and put extra sauce on the rejection. That way they can show their colleagues and their peers, girl, yeah, he tried to talk to me. Look what I told him. And then it gets lonely, because you think these men that you're rejecting, that this Superman is going to be waiting when they're watching you put these men that are genuinely trying to take interest in some cases. In some cases, they're trying to buy what you're selling because of your advertising. You think quality men are going to be waiting on the other end of the rainbow after you shit on these men? See, the bag is out. I'm going to do another video, which is going to put the modern woman on trial. For so long, the male has taken the brunt of accountability and responsibility for the chaos in our communities. But now, as these male spaces have exploded, the truth has come out. And now the woman, the modern woman, is on trial, and she can't face the music. She can't take it. That's why she tries to share responsibility every opportunity she gets. She's held to the fire. She's going to try to pull the man in with him. But when the statistics come out that they're the most educated, they're the highest earning, they don't share that. They don't share that stage. They don't share that responsibility and accountability. Now, do they? They want to own that in its entirety. But if you own one, you have to own the other. It's the Date Master.